place, would you raise your hands to the Father right now? Everybody lifting those hands. Say, Holy Spirit, you're welcome in this place. Do you feel him tonight? Come on, everybody say peace. Come on, shout it out. Say peace. Somebody say love. Somebody say hallelujah. Come on, sanctuary, put your hands together like this. Hey!
Up to you, dancing on the ding dong.
Oh, I see you. Sing with me. Hey. If not for your mercy, if not for your grace, don't know where I'd be, low on happy days. Thank you for your mercy, thank you for your grace. I smile cause I feel much better now. Everybody say, peace, love, hallelujah.
No one gets up to you.
Somebody give him a shout of praise right now. Hey.
I'm
sanctuary. Want to hear you sing this nice and loud. Sing it, Jesse. You sing this. Say it.
Sing a little louder.
You say.
Sing a little louder. Sing a little louder.
Come on. Say.
Sing a little louder. Sing a little louder. Sing a little louder. You can sing a little louder. Sing a little louder. Sing a little louder. In the presence of my enemy. Sing a little louder. Sing louder than the unbelief. Yeah. Sing a little louder. Whoa, whoa.
Feel good or what? Woo, you guys are a singing bunch, man. Woo. Ooh. Thank you, family. You may be seated. That's the truth, right? And especially after the couple of years that we've had, what a miracle to be here tonight. And never to make light of the situation that the world has been through since 2020. I remember that everything, when it all shut down, we were freaking out just like everybody else. But Jesus is the same yesterday, you know, through a pandemic, without it, he's the same yesterday, today, and forever. So it's just such an honor to be here with you all. And we thank our dear friends, Pastor Jay. The Haizlips are just, I know you know this, but you have some of the best, the greatest pastors in all of the world here at the sanctuary. You've been a blessing to our family. You know, I remember we moved to Nashville, Tennessee in 1993. We were living out in the Northwest, and man, we, you know, change when you're kind of pulled out of your comfort zone, it's never an easy thing. Nobody likes that, like, at least naturally. I know we were really uncomfortable with that. But we found ourselves in Nashville, Tennessee, where, you know, sweet people, but they look at us and like, man, you ain't white, you ain't black, where you from? And so we would tell them, man, we're originally from the South Pacific Islands of American Samoa. And see, people in here in California, that's, you know, you see that, you know our culture, but those sweet people would look at us and they'd say, oh, God bless you. Which later on we found out that in the South, that means I feel sorry for you. But we've, through the transition and being like fish out of water, God gave us this next song. And he reminded us through these lyrics, the lyrics of the chorus say, every time I hear your voice, every time I feel your touch, it lets me know that I can face tomorrow one more time. And it's true for all of you. God's got you. He knows your past, he knows your present, and he knows your future. He knows where he's staying.
Lord, I saw your face last night when I looked in the sky. You were smiling. You told me it would be okay. When all my friends go away, I'll be glad to say you're still near me. Even when the wind blows by, I feel warm inside. You're so you, I can't serve.
Thank you so much, man. Aren't you grateful for that? You know, I know that there's got to be some here that experienced those days where you didn't want to wake up in the morning, you know, because of something that you may have been going through. But we're here tonight because we're just a testimony of God's grace and His redemption, His restoration, and. It would take us all night to speak of His goodness. The last time we were here at the sanctuary, between the five brothers, we had 19 kids. And we still have 19 kids. I believe that the factory is closed, and you know, God, Jesus said, I'm the Alpha and the Omega. And so, we're so grateful for all 19 of them, and my wife and our family were especially excited because our daughter Caitlin will be getting married this month, later on this month, March 26th. We're excited, and one day we were together at our office, and we got together to write, which we do often, and on that day, there's a wall in the office that has all 19 of their pictures, and so we just started thanking God for all of them, and we thank God for being an amazing God, and none of us share the same fingerprints, and He's made everyone unique, and that's what we started writing about, and we titled this song 19. It's a song about our kids, but we want to sing this song to each and every one of you. The words of the chorus, they're just words full of life. I love that song that the worship team was singing. Nothing is impossible. Yeah. It's all possible. God's got a plan. And so let this song encourage you. But before we get into the song 19, take a look at the screen. Here's our 19 kids.
The word family means having a good time, I guess.
Just people being there for you in your corner no matter what.
Family doesn't always have to be blood, just the people you love and surround yourself with. One way my family has helped me grow over time is by supporting me no matter what.
I'm so thankful for a family that cares enough about me to be there with me in good times and bad times.
My family has helped me in a lot of ways by pulling me down the right direction, no matter what obstacle we face.
My family is not perfect.
Well, no one's perfect.
We're just like every other family. We struggle with the same things that anyone else would.
Everybody makes mistakes, but family's there to help you.
By encouraging me and pushing me to be a better person.
One thing that I've learned from this family that I'll make sure to instill into my next family is love always.
Just the unity. We're all here for each other, and we're by each other's sides.
To be humble, to be thankful for the things that you have, and to work hard.
They make it obvious that they love you, and I wanna make that evident for my kids and my family too.
As long as you know that there's always gonna be people supporting you, behind you, and through whatever you do, then you're gonna be okay.
so much.
Thank you.
We wrote some songs during the whole lockdown and the shutdown, and we want to sing one of those songs for you. Is that all right? Say, everything is going to be all right.
How will we get through these days? At least that's what they say.
Believe that everything will be all right. This is so cool. What do you do on a Thursday night in Costa Mesa? You come to the sanctuary.
Yes. Yes, sir.
We've been here a few times, but would you welcome on the bass guitar? This is my brother James.
Love you guys.
Singing leads with me. This is James's twin. This is John.
Yes. Thank you.
Back on the drums, that's our brother Joe. And I'm Jesse. I don't know why our parents did James, John, Joe, and Jesse. Give it up for Brother Sam.
Yes.
We want you to know that in the back we have some of our merchandise and our latest apparel that came out. But we're so excited to bring to you our latest record. It came out a few months ago. It has a lot of familiar worship songs that you probably sing right here in the sanctuary throughout the week. We sang I Raise a Hallelujah, Waymaker, Mighty River. So would you please do me a favor and pick this up? And if you don't have a CD player, you can download it on Apple Music and Amazon and iTunes. It's all on there, Spotify. And we know that it'll be a blessing to you. And we have some apparel right here. John, could you hold this maroon hoodie right there?
Yep.
This is our latest T-shirt. And we've been selling this for a while because this is really the mission of our lives. This is what our mom raised us on, to love God and to love people. It's black on black, so we got it back there. We have this maroon hoodie, and it says, it has this logo, Love Squared.
It's cold. It's cold here, so everybody get one of these.
Love God, Love People logo, and this one just came out. This is specifically for women. It's a beach hoodie, and has a flower print on there. It has that logo, Love Squared, it's available back there. Guys, do not buy this. This is just for women.
Yeah,
right?
buy it for your wife, your girlfriend.
And as Sam said, Sam talked about our 19 kids. They still eat a lot, so please buy yourself a hoodie, a CD, and you'll bless us.
All proceeds go to Feed Hungry Children, our own.
As you can tell, we're all about family, and that's why we feel right at home here. We're with our friend, Pastor Jay. Pastor Christian, we saw him earlier. And speaking of family, so we used to do an event on a cruise ship, like 5 days. It was awesome. And then for obvious reasons, the last 2 years, that was not possible anymore. So this year, for the very first time, and again, this is going to be a family event, we are doing something in Nashville called the Katinas and Cousins Nashville Reunion, and it's a 3-day event. I don't know if you've been to Nashville, but Nashville's a cool town. But more than that, we're excited because when we say reunion, that's what it's going to be. It's going to be 3 days of music. We're going to be having dinner together. We're going to have like karaoke afterwards. We're going to have outdoor devotions. It's amazing. So many people from around the country, different parts of the world are coming to Nashville. If that's been on your bucket list, we invite you. We're going to have a great time. You'll meet many of our 19 kids, our wives. So there's a QR code. I don't know if you spot it. If you want to grab your phone and just snap that, it'll give you all the information. We've got like VIP packages, couples packages, groups. There's a lot of singles and groups that are coming. So and it's limited, so this is our first one. We're believing it's going to be an annual thing. 3 days with the cousins, with the Katinas. We'd love for you to come right along with us. Yeah, wouldn't be good, John?
If you love country music, any country music lover?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Have you ever heard country music from some Samoan brothers? Because we got a surprise for you.
We got one country song.
We got one country song that we wrote. So come on out. And,
yeah, come out. It's going to be amazing. As we were talking, you know, there's been a lot going on. I remember, brothers, when everything shut down. This was right around March of 2020. We actually just got back from the South Pacific. We were doing a little tour out there. And our next event, I believe we were coming to California, was canceled. And we still didn't know what was going on, and we just thought, oh, okay, well, we'll get to be home for a week, you know, and it turned into 3 weeks, and then it turned into 3 months, and it was, now, we enjoyed it. Like, we loved having home-cooked meals, and we were home, and I remember probably after that first 3 weeks, first month, my wife looked at me and said, honey, don't you have somewhere to go? And I said, no, we're here for a while. But we did. We would go to our little writing room, have a little studio in our office, and I think early on it was just for therapy. We were concerned, like the rest of the world, all of the uncertainty that was going on, and so we would just write. Sometimes it was just melodies, some chord changes, and then on one particular writing session, there was a word, just one lyric that was on repeat, and it was the word here, H-E-R-E. And God was reminding us that in the midst of all that was going on, in the midst of us freaking out, that he was here, that he was with us through it all, and that it was okay. It was okay to be in our feelings sometimes, but just to know that he would never leave us. He would never forsake us. And I don't know what you're going through. You know, fast forward to March of 2022. Perhaps you might still be in that place where you're feeling this anxiety, this uncertainty. We just came all the way from Nashville to remind you, just as your brothers, as your sons, that everything's going to be okay, that Jesus loves you perfectly. He's here with you no matter what. So just listen to the lyrics of this song. Hopefully it ministers to you.
Where the heavens die. Tonight's family night, Pastor told us, and we're honored to be with you, because we know this about families. Families are beautiful. Families are brutal. People ask us, they say, dude, you all are real brothers. Do you love each other? Yeah. Honest answer, most of the time. Who's married here? Anybody married here? Sweet. Sweet. Single. Who's single? Sweet. So good. Yes. I read an article last night about single people. You know, sometimes you come to church and I don't think people mean it, but sometimes you being single is not celebrated like it should be. I just want to remind you, single, there are some things you can do that married people can't do. Yeah. God can use you in mighty ways. I don't hear what I'm not saying. There's some things you shouldn't do that married people can do. Yeah. But we celebrate you here at the sanctuary. We're glad you're here. You have gifts, so many gifts. And so before we sing this next song, I just want to quickly talk about, in my little experience, about what makes the ingredients of a happy family. Not a happy family, a healthy family. Because a healthy family is not always happy. And the ingredients of a healthy family. Number one, failure is part of the process. See, failure is not the opposite of success. Success, failure is part of success. And sometimes we think when our families start going through problems, you're like, what's wrong with our family? When we travel, people, especially moms, they hear that we're brothers and that we're married and we have 19 kids. And they're like, man, I wish my family was like your family. I got good news and bad news. The good news is your family's just like our family. The bad news, your family's just like our family. Failure is part of the process. In Philippians 3, 13 and 14, it says, brothers and sisters, I do not consider myself to have taken control of it or have apprehended it. But one thing I do, forgetting what is behind, pressing towards what is ahead so I can reach the mark of the high calling in Jesus. Forgetting all the good, forgetting all the bad, the mistakes. And I got to be honest with you, sometimes when people have, maybe they haven't heard us in a while, and they'll hear us and they're like, dude, the Spirit of God is so strong on you. Where does that come from? Sometimes it comes from prayer. Other times it comes from pain. Sometimes it comes because we are doing well. And sometimes it's because we messed up so bad and we realize outside of God's grace for our family and for our mistakes and for our failures, we don't have a shot. So failure is part of the process. Secondly, forgiveness is necessary for growth. There used to be a show back in the day when we were younger. None of you were born back then. And it said, true love is never having to say I'm sorry. That is the biggest lie I've ever heard. If you've been married for any amount of time, divorced and remarried, you know that forgiveness and saying I'm sorry is done over and over and over. Yeah. It never ends. Forgiveness. Our dad is a retired Marine, Pentecostal preacher. That's not a good combo when you're a kid. So we grow up, Pastor. He didn't show a whole lot of affection. Now, our mother was all love. Anything we know about love, we learn about from our mom. Well, then about 34 years ago, mom passed away after a battle of cancer. Mom was 50 when she passed away. I was 17. When we were 17, 50 seems old. Mm-hmm. Now I'm 52. I'm like, man, my mom was young. And so when we thought our family was healthy, we realize that not our mom was not only the glue, she was the bridge to our father. We were scared of our dad. We had no relationship with our dad. He didn't allow us to fail, it seemed. And it seemed like no matter what we did, it was never enough. Some of you can relate. Several years ago, when our family was, it just seemed so broken, my dad called us. He had gone through some rehab for military veterans for 8 weeks, and he called us. Now, remember, my dad is a pastor. He had been helping people all his life, talking about God's love, talking about how God can restore families, and yet our family was just falling apart. And I remember him calling us on the phone. We were all in Sam's living room on a speakerphone, and he said, Sam, Joe, James, John, and Jesse, I'm so sorry. Would you please forgive me? I've never told you, but I'm so proud of you. He said, I realized recently that the only reason you are decent adults is because of God's grace and the prayers of your mom. Would you please forgive me? He said, I knew I was going to call you. I called your other brothers and sisters. There's 12 of us. And he said, but I've been wondering, how do I ask the person that I need the most forgiveness from? She's no longer here. He said, I wrote this letter and I climbed up this mountain by where I'm staying at. And when I got to the top, I read it to your mom, boys. He said, when I left the mountaintop, I didn't hear an audible voice, but I know that mom's forgiven me too. Jesus said, forgive and you will be forgiven. Lewis Smead says, to forgive is to release a prisoner only to realize that prisoner was you. You want a healthy family? Forgive. Forgiveness is necessary for growth. Finally, faith in Jesus is what keeps you moving together in the right direction. Faith in Jesus alone. So I want to say this to you families. I don't know where you're at on your journey. Maybe you've just been through a divorce. Maybe you're struggling. Maybe somebody in your family is battling an addiction. Maybe you look around and you wish you were part of somebody else's family. Grass is not greener on the other side. Grass is greener where you water it. With faithfulness, forgiveness. So wherever you are, we want you to know, as that song said, God's here for you.
Yeah.
Pastor's going to come up later on and give you an opportunity for healing, to receive health in your family. And so this is our blessing for you and your family. May the God of all hope fill you with joy and peace as you trust in him. And may you overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. May the road rise up to meet you and the wind be always at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face and the rains fall soft upon your fields. And until we meet again, may God hold you and your family in the palm of his hands.
Shine.
Come on, family, would you stand your feet all over this place? God, we thank you for your goodness. We thank you for family. Father, we thank you that you placed each one of us in a specific family, Lord. Strengthen our families right now in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
God is so good. Saying God is so good. God is so good. He's so good to me. He's so good to me.
Sing about his goodness. Come on, cousins, lift your voice and you sing.
I love you, Lord, for your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, will say of the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful,
Lord.
And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath of the good.
you sang.
Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything.
Talking about your goodness.
Your goodness
and
is
your
running
mercy,
after.
Lord.
It's running after.
Come on,
me.
Sanctuary. Say it.
Your goodness is running after. It's running after me.
I'm alive and well.
Your goodness is running after.
Transform.
It's running after.
You know, the best part of tonight has not yet happened, but it's about to happen. Yeah.